guess I'll just expand on what I was saying regarding the animal shelter, that as I've been saying for the past year, that my hope story has caused the shelter to spiral downwards, and that finally, over the past few months, we haven't had to approach anyone. We don't approach anyone. We keep telling people, we can't fight for you. You've got to come in here and fight for those animals and expose what's happening. And that's what I've tried to warn you about the past year, and that's what's taking place. And these people are determined to get the kind of leader that you did get in previously, Kate Murray. I believe that you want to see the shelter get better. You wouldn't be doing what you're doing for the pet stores and those laws if you didn't care. I just need to point out to you that it's going to take your action to fix this. And I don't believe this can be fixed with Mike Pastore at the wheel. I saw it coming. We were just at the point, advocates, of saying when Cindy and Stacy were in and we saw things thriving and the programs were finally developed and the volunteers and staff were literally skipping around that shelter and the dogs all had buddies and the cats were getting promoted. And then that all ended with one wrong leader. And the leader is everything in an animal shelter. I'm happy to see Susan Hansen is here. We happen to be sitting. The same advocates that you probably are not always happy to see. Smithtown has embraced us and they sit us on advisory committees for the shelter. Not just that, we were on an interview committee. It wasn't that hard to pick out Susan Hansen, and she's outstanding. And the difference between Susan is that versus Mike. Mike came into that animal shelter, and the first things he did was to reinstate that prisoner-like sign-in book that Stacy and Cindy did away with, giving it more of an adoption feel. And he also put on the bolt lock. But when the public comes in feeling like, oh boy, okay, I have to wait for the buzzer for what am I visiting here, a penitentiary? He put those two things in. I had a brief conversation when I heard from Susan. She starts tomorrow. I said, how are things going? She said, great, I met the staff, I'm encouraged. She said, but the next day I went back and I put in a suggestion box on the office counter because I want to know what the staff thinks and the community and the volunteers. And it blew me away. And that's good leadership. And that's what you need to start looking at. And I hope you'll consider that. And I hope you do fix this because it's a situation that, as you can see, is worsening. And people get stronger when they hear other people speak out. So when these videotapes come out and they hear these individuals speaking, they're going to find the courage to speak too. Thank you.